Hi, and welcome back to Computer Science for Everyone. This time we're going to go through what inheritance is and how we program it. So, as we've seen in the lecture, in order to do inheritance, we need more than one class. So what I'm going to do here is I'm going to create a new project, and I'm going to call it animals, for example. And what I'm going to do in this project is I'm going to create a class. It's going to be animal. It's not going to have a main method because this is just going to hold functionality for an animal. It's not actually going to run the program. And I'm going to put here some properties and behavior that are common to all animals. So, for example, age. Those two. And you might wonder now, why am I using public instead of private? If you were not wondering this, then this is something you should wonder about. Usually I'm making all my variables private whenever possible, and then using getters and setters in order to get them and set them. So why do I use public now? Other classes are going to be inheriting from this class these properties, and we agree that if I set these to private, no other class can use these properties. That includes subclasses. So is public then the only choice? Well, good job on wondering why am I using public, because actually public is not the best choice to use here. Apart from public and private, there is a third method that lets subclasses use the properties, but no other class. And this is called protected. So now any subclasses can access these two properties, but no external class to this hierarchy can access them. So we have the age and the color, and we just need to create our getters and setters. So in order to get the age, we do this. We create the method getAge that's going to return a string, an int. So whenever we call this method, we're going to get the age value for this animal. And string getColor is going to return the color string for this animal, or any other animal of which the object is created. And then we also need to create setters. So what this is going to do is going to allow us to change the value of age. It takes a parameter, which is a, an integer, and then sets the value of age equal to the value of a we give the method. This way, we can change the values for age and color. Like so. If you remember what the constructor is, the constructor is what gets called when we create a new object, and we can also give it some parameters. So what we can do is we can create two constructors. One of them doesn't take any parameters. And the other one does. So one constructor would just create an animal with no age or color, essentially like an empty animal that doesn't have anything in it, and that we have to initialize with the set color and set age methods. And the other one would let us initialize age and color to two values that we give the constructor. Like so. So if we use this constructor, we would not have to use the setters. If we use this one, then we would have to use the setters, because in this one we already create the object with two age and color values. Whereas with this constructor, we initialize the animal without an age or color value. Okay, so let's say that these are the kind of common properties to all animals. I'm sure there are many more, but let's just leave it at that for now. And then we'll create a new class that I'm going to call dog. the superclass of dog is no longer going to be object, but we will change that in code instead of here so it's easier for you to see. So we have our dog, and a dog is going to extend the functionality of animal. Like so. So now, even if we leave this class empty, we can use these methods in our dog, which is brilliant. This lets us put this functionality that is common to all animals inside the animal class, and then our dog class is a lot smaller. Let me create a class that is going to run our program with a main method. I'm going to call it tester, but you can call it whatever you want. And this class is going to create a dog object. And then here you see that the dog itself has getAge, getColor, setAge, and setColor methods. So we can set the age of the dog to be 5. And then we can print the age, like so. And there you have the value 5, which is the age we gave the dog. So as you can see, even though the dog doesn't have anything in it, because it's extending the functionality of animal, those methods that are not the constructor, so all of these, are now present in our dog class. And now we can put more things in it. The first thing we want to do, however, is create the constructors. So what I'm doing here is I'm calling the superclasses constructor. So if I create a dog with no parameters, I simply call the animal constructor with no parameters. This is done by default, and you could, in theory, ignore it. I'm just going to put it there for the sake of explanation. So I create a dog with no parameters, and I call the animal constructor, which is this one, with no parameters either. So we create essentially an empty animal and an empty dog. I can, however, create a dog giving it an age and a color value. And then I call the constructor of the superclass that takes those two parameters as well. So here, what I'm calling is this. So I'm creating an animal with an age and a color that is also given to this constructor. Try to visualize the hierarchy in your head so that it's easier for you to understand. We can also, apart from extending the functionality of animal, we can create more functionality specific to a dog. And we have already created this in other lectures. For example, bark could woof, for example. And now, if we have a dog and we create an animal, we cannot do a.bark. So you can see this bark method is not there. However, we have getAge, getColor, setAge, and setColor. And our D has bark. So we can play this, and there we have the woof, which is unique to dog, and 5, which isn't. We could then continue this hierarchy by creating a Shiba Inu dog, for example, that would extend dog, and it would have the properties of dog and also those of animal. I'm not going to do that because that would take a long time. But this is the basics of inheritance. You can create classes that extend other classes, extend the functionality of other classes by inheriting their functionality. And similarly, you can make protected variables that this class can access. And you can make private variables that subclasses can't access if they are unique to that class. So just for example, if I created a dog that had, a private bark property that would be what it's barking, and then different dogs bark differently. Each dog could have its own private version of the bark string, and then that would be printed out here. What I mean with this is that if I do this, and then I extend the dog I extend from doesn't have this property because it's not protected. So then other dogs would have to have their own bark properties to be able to bark in their different ways. Okay, so let's leave it this at that. If you find this really complicated and you have no idea what's going on, please go ahead and ask a question on the Udemy course page. You can do that and I will answer. However, I think it's really quite simple. It's just having some functionality that other classes can extend so that your classes end up being encapsulating the behavior and the properties that are common to all classes which are under the class you're creating. So all the properties that are common to all animals are in the class animal, and then all animals extend animal. And they create some more common properties to all dogs, but all animals have the same properties that come from the animal class. This is the basics of inheritance, so hopefully that is not difficult to understand. If it is, go ahead and ask questions and I will reply. So thank you for watching, and let's go into the next section. There's going to be really interesting, and it's going to start getting a bit more complicated as well. So I'll see you there.